Okay, so it's been quite some time since we last published our benchmark results with the brand new Zephyrus Duo 15SE GX551Q, and it packs the brand new AMD Ryzen 9 5900HX, NVIDIA GeForce RTX 3080 laptop, 32 gigs of RAM, and double 1TB NVMe SSDs in RAID 0. But at the end of the first benchmark video that we did, we said this. Now, I would suggest you to take our test here with a grain of salt because number one, this driver is pre-release. So when you ever buy this laptop, new drivers might come out, so the performance might change here and there. And today, we have new drivers, new BIOS, new updates that you will get if you buy the Zephyrus Duo 15SE GX551Q today. So what actually happened between the time when we published our first video and also right now? Number one, we got a brand new NVIDIA GPU driver, of course, because once the embargo has lifted, NVIDIA straight out sent a brand new driver which is newer than the one that we tested with, obviously. And then ASUS also published a brand new NVIDIA GPU BIOS update. Yes, GPUs have BIOS as well, and it has been updated through the ASUS utility called the Live Update tool. Yeah, and it also claims to have improved GPU performance as well. Now, this actually enabled addressable bar as well, which means that the CPU can directly access all of the GPU's VRAM at once, but there is no real way to disable or enable it. There's no real way to check if it's working as well. So one of the methods that ASUS told us is that you can head into Control Panel, go into Device Manager, head into your display adapter, head into the GPU itself, and then click into Resources, and then you can see there's something with the resource type called Large Memory Range, and with that Large Memory Range means that it's resizable bar enabled. And of course, ASUS also issued a brand new BIOS update for this laptop. We initially tested with BIOS version 400, and ASUS actually pushed out BIOS version 401, which fixed a few weird quirks here and there that we discovered. So yeah. Anyway, let's start off with the benchmark, and we've also added a game, and all of the other existing games are done with the exact same graphical settings that we used in the first test, but now in three different resolutions. So we tested at 1080p, 1440p, and then 2160p, also known as 4K. Now, first off, we'll start off once again with Cyberpunk 2077, and at 1080p resolution, with maximum raster graphics settings and medium ray tracing and DLSS set to balance, we got about 45 to 58 FPS in that range. Now, the brick frame rate discrepancy here is mostly due to how the scenes affect ray tracing, and we can see that this is somewhat bottlenecked by its RT cores because we can see at the top right corner there, both the CPU and GPU are not running at 100% utilization. And then at 1440p resolution though, with the exact same graphical settings, we get about mostly around 40 to 50 FPS. Sometimes it drops to all the way down to 35 FPS, but we also saw it drop to as low as 33 FPS, but generally I would say it's at a very playable frame rate, and honestly, yeah, you can actually get by playing with these settings at 1440p resolution. But when we up it all the way to 4K resolution though, it actually improved quite a lot with the brand new updates. So now we got mostly at around 30 FPS as opposed to the original 27 FPS before the update. And sometimes it also still drops to 27 FPS, but sometimes it also goes all the way up to 32 to 33 FPS, somewhere around that. And then lastly, we disabled ray tracing and DLSS together, so it's just at ultra graphical settings. And at 1080p, we got mostly at around 60 FPS, and that is good. But sometimes it does drop all the way down to about 50 FPS, but generally it's still really smooth all the way through. And then at 1440p though, the range is a bit wider, so we can see frame rates from about 37 all the way to about 48 FPS. It kind of depends on how busy the scene is as well. And then at 4K resolution, we were managing at around 22 to about 24 FPS, and that's it. It's just the GPU can't handle it at 4K without the DLSS. Now, enough about Cyberpunk. Let's move on with GTA 5. And with the same settings as before at 1080p resolution this time around, we managed to get at around 60 to 80 FPS and it's consistent as well. So we will say that if you want to play this game at highest graphical settings with that smooth 60 FPS, you can. And then at 1440p, we got at around 48 to 55 frames per second, which is still okay actually. It managed better than I expected. Now for 4K resolution. During our first test, we managed to only get about 15 FPS at 4K. But after all of the updates, now we got at around 30 FPS, which is a huge improvement over the pre-update test. And I have no idea what kind of optimization they did because the overall power consumption is essentially still the same. And now comes CSGO. I know that no one plays this kind of esports games with the highest graphical settings, but hey, we are only here to test the laptop's performance. And at 1080p, we got at around 180 to about 200 FPS. And then at 1440p, we got at around 165 to about 180 FPS, which is still way beyond the refresh rate of this laptop here. But at 4K, we managed to get at around 110 to 125 FPS, which is still a huge improvement over the initial test that we did before the update. And lastly, COD Warzone. One of the commenters requested it, so we might as well add it in, right? And at the highest graphical settings with ray tracing turned on, actually, we jumped into a game of Battle Royale, and at 1080p, we got at about 110 FPS, and it was nearly hitting the limit on the CPU, GPU, and also the VRAM, so yeah. And at 1440p, we still got at around 90 FPS, which I think is surprisingly really good, even though ray tracing is turned on. And then at 4K resolution, we got at around 60 FPS, which I think is really good for a laptop with these graphical settings. And that's it, that's all of our brand new round of tests for the Zephyrus Duo 15 SE GX551Q with the AMD Ryzen 5900HX and also the brand new NVIDIA RTX 3080 laptop GPU. And in terms of temperatures though, we ran synthetic tests once again and we managed to get the CPU at around nearly 90 degrees whereas the GPU is at about 86 degrees. And wattage. Alright, wattage. So the CPU still maxes out at around 50 watts, which is to be expected. And ASUS claims that this GPU can max out at 130 watts, but from what we have seen, it doesn't actually sit at 130 watts. It just only spike up for a split second and then essentially just drop back down to 120 watts sustained. So yeah, and back to one of the points that we made in the initial video. NVIDIA's brand new naming scheme, without the distinction of Max-P, Max-Q, or maybe just listing the maximum wattage in the GPU name itself, will confuse quite a lot of users. And we've already seen that happening with some other laptops in the market right now. Yeah, it's gonna be a real headache time for whoever is wanting to buy a brand new laptop with the new RTX 30 series of laptop chips. So yeah, that's it. We'll see you in the next video. Have a good day. Stay safe.